Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour. And with me again is Matthew Roche, who's a senior program manager for Microsoft.
Good morning, Jay. Thank you very much for having me here.
So, Matthew, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a senior program manager on the SQL Server team, so I work to build the features and capabilities in the next versions of SQL Server. Before I joined Microsoft just over 5 years ago, I was a business intelligence consultant, so working with SQL Server, doing data warehousing and BI solutions.
And that's really convenient because we're here to talk about 7466, implementing data models and reporting with Microsoft SQL Server 2012. And that is an MCSC exam for the business intelligence MCSC.
Yep.
So, Matthew, this exam picks up right where 463 left off, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Even though you can take the exams in either order, whatever order you want, if you think about a business intelligence solution, typically you're starting with your OLTP solutions, or your OLTP systems, rather. So those systems where you're pulling the data from, you're loading them into your data mart or data warehouse in the relational database. And once that's done, and that's, those are the things that are covered in the 463, once that's done, your next step is to build out the high-performance OLAP model, be it in a multidimensional analysis services cube or perhaps in the tabular model, and then build the data visualization, you know, reporting the scorecards and such on top of it. And really, that covers the BI application lifecycle end-to-end. Two exams. You can take them in either order, but logically, we're picking up where 463 leaves off.
And now, you mentioned data models. There's really two types of data models that this exam covers. Can you explain that?
Yep. So if you think about if you think about where SQL Server has come from, starting in SQL Server 7 when OLAP services were introduced, up through the current day, the multidimensional model has really been the primary analytic model. So if you think about, I'm going to do the visualization with my hands here. So think about a cube of data.
Yep.
So remember that we have our dimensions of data, which are the things that we measure our facts by. So a fact is typically a number, something that you can aggregate up. I want to look at sales by region, by employee, and by date.
Yeah.
So we've got those three dimensions, the three different views of the cube or sides of the cube that we can slice and dice the data by.
Uh-huh.
So this multidimensional model, not limited to three dimensions, you can have as many dimensions as are appropriate for your data. This has been the most traditional way that SQL Server has approached data modeling. Starting in SQL Server 2008 R2 and the Power Pivot add-in for Excel, we've introduced another in-memory high-performance model called the VertiPack or X-Velocity engine, which is represented as the tabular model in SQL Server. Essentially, each one of them has strengths and weaknesses, which you should probably understand when you're going in for the exam. The multidimensional model has more enterprise features. So if you think about partitioning or scaling out, the multidimensional model may be more in line with what you're looking for. If you're thinking about ease of use and ease of understanding, even from a developer's perspective, the tabular model is more like the relational model that many database professionals are familiar with. So lower cost of entry and also better integration with a lot of the self-service BI capabilities that we're delivering in Excel.
And here I thought the multi-dimensional cube was just a Doctor Who thing.
Well, if you think about it, your multi-dimensional cube actually has more data on the inside than on the outside, so it fits in pretty well.
Okay. MDX is something even you, Johnny BI, had a little bit of trouble with.
Yeah, so multidimensional expressions, the MDX language, is the query language on top of those cubes.
Mm-hmm.
And if you think about it, if you were asked to solve a problem in a fourth dimensional or eighth dimensional space, you're rolling your eyes.
Yeah, I'm cringing.
Yeah, it's not the way that our brains are designed to work. So MDX, which is covered in several different parts of this exam, is one of the more conceptually difficult things that a BI professional needs to master. Typically, it's not something that I've had a lot of strength in. I've worked with some great people that I could rely on to write the MDX for KPIs or other functions inside of my cubes. One of the advantages of the tabular model over the multidimensional model is the fact that it has what are called data access expressions or DAX expressions.
Okay.
So a function language that is similar to the expression language inside of Excel, a little bit more intuitive and a little bit more familiar. MDX is something you should study for the exam. Even if you use it on a day-to-day basis, make sure that you know your stuff. And it's probably something that you will look up from time to time out there in the real world.
Okay. So let's wrap up with once we have all this data, why is it important to show it in a cohesive fashion?
Well, I guess the most important thing is the data doesn't solve a problem. It's not part of the solution until your business users can get to it. The data visualization, be it reporting, dashboarding, scorecarding, however you want to think about it, it's really a matter of making the data that's inside your BI solution accessible to the end users, to those business users, because remember it is business intelligence, to make sure that they can get the data out in the format and with the interactivity that they need. This exam covers SQL Server reporting services from an implementation perspective, so you'll need to understand how to build the reports, how to put interactivity and logic inside your reports, how to choose the right reporting approach and solution based on the business needs that you've got.
And, of course, if you don't have the skills to show the value of that data, then what's the point in having it, really?
Well, exactly. So until a business user can work with the data that you've put into this into the analysis services cube or tabular model to get that information back out, it's not actually delivering value to the business. That's what business intelligence is all about.
Yep. Okay. Well, thanks for being here, Matthew. I really appreciate it.
Thank you very much for having me, Jay.
So we've been talking about 7466, which is implementing data models and reporting with Microsoft SQL Server 2012, and it's for the MCSE Business Intelligence. Go take that exam.